Drink by the campfire. Skate on the ice. Buy a lean horse and a tempered sword. Do these things and be pleased with your lot.
Good morrow, good morrow. I stand here on behalf of the Lady Yelette of Colchester, famed mistress of the flight. Do you seek an audience?
I have never heard of her.
Based on your appearance, I'm thoroughly unsurprised. Nevertheless, do you wish to challenge her?
I do.
Foolish. Yet to be graced by her presence may balance the pain of the loss you will most assuredly suffer. Lady Yelette, you are called to the field of flighting.
Ah, a peasant. Come for a sound flighting? Please, place your paltry bet.
Take this.
A pittance. But I accept on the lady's behalf. She will begin.
I have heard much about you, and none of it good. You've the softness and brains of a sheep. My verses are known all across this great land.
For they put all who hear them to sleep.
Not bad.
Oh, you think you're so clever, I'm almost impressed that you managed to blurt something out. Yet I worry our skills are too deeply mismatched.
I'll defeat you and banish all doubt.
Lucky.
I should almost take pity on one so bereft of beauty, of wit, and of skill. But instead, I'll persist till you beg me to stop.
Lend a soul for your words make me ill.
Where did you steal that one from?
Thus the Lady Yelette has been beaten at last by the one she was foolish to doubt. Now her herald must give me the sum of my bet, while Yelette can but stand there and pout.
Oh, pay what is due and send this peasant away. I grow weary.
Of course, milady. Take your winnings, you have earned them.
Thank you.
Let's see what lies in store.
This looks like an old cellar. The air reeks of stale wine. Are those barrels still full? A shaft. I can see something at the bottom, but it's out of my reach. Mine has filled the shaft, bearing my prize with it. I should be able to reach it now. A drinking horn. It looks valuable. A good find, I think.